It's Christmas time. There's no need to be afraid. It's Christmas time. Well, it's Christmas time. Rocking around the Christmas tree. Come on, everybody, let's rock. Raise your fist, you can guarantee that the party never stops. Have a
having a wonderful Christmas time. We're simply having a wonderful Christmas time.
All right. This is Bum Wine Bob welcoming you to an all-new edition of Bumming with Bobcat, and it wouldn't be the holiday season without a special holiday episode. And joining us, as a tradition now, as it's been for the past few years, I am happy to welcome back Aaron and Uncle from Uncle the Podcast. How you guys doing tonight?
Okay.
Yeah, we're doing great. Thanks for having us back.
Hey, no, thanks for coming back on. It's been a year. It's the holidays again, and we're always happy to have you on here and have some drinks. So I don't need an excuse to drink. So if you guys are here with me, that's even better.
Yep. Don't need one, but you got one. So all the better. Yeah.
I'll take it.
I have to test. I have to test this one anyway that we have.
Yeah, we're excited.
I haven't
about
tested
this.
It, but I believe this guy did. But he's not saying any number.
Yeah, no, he's not. He's not giving out any hints or anything. He's not trying to sway your judgment anyway, which is good. You don't want.
Yeah.
I'm the same way too. But before I have a new drink or something new comes out, I try to stay away from any reviews.
Exactly. Or that's what I try to do. That's what I try to do. But he did a no-no.
You got to be impartial. It's like a legal proceeding here.
Exactly. Yeah, we take this job very seriously here when it comes to drink reviews.
Yeah, I know. I do. But he doesn't get the picture yet.
I'm a little drink more reviews. Relaxed.
Well, I mean, well, Aaron, yeah. Did you get this for the sake of trying to do it for either your show or a different show, or did you just get this just because you wanted to try it at one point? So it wasn't like spoiling it.
Yeah, I mean, this beer caught my eye recently. I was up in 29 Palms. A friend was like doing a DJ event at the Out There Bar in 29 Palms, and he walked up to us and he was holding one of these drinks. It's got a really interesting look to it. Like, what the heck is that drink? He's like, oh, it's Montucky. It's from Montana. It's good. Mm-hmm. So I saw it there. I'm like, oh, okay, that's cool. So it's just been on my mind. It's like, oh. And you know, we had to come up with something here. I figured it might be something that you could find, and it's something that I wanted to have, so that's the story.
Yeah, it's something different. So we'll let the people know that what we brought along here is we're celebrating a cold snack Christmas this year, and this is the Montucky cold snack 12. Well, at least when I have the 12. I don't know. Do you guys have the 12-ounce can, or do you have a big can over there?
We've got the 16s.
Ooh, okay, big boys there. So this, because mine says 12 ounces of refreshment.
Yeah. Oh, that's half the can. Yeah. That's not even 3/4 of the can that we're gonna drink here.
Ours says 16 ounces. Okay. Of refreshment. Okay. Yeah.
This right. is more of a 16, not a 12-pound.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I don't know. You guys ready? I'm feeling a little parched over here. I'm a little thirsty. You want to crack this bad boy open and give it a shot?
Let's get right into it.
All right. Let's
pop this open.
Ooh, there we go.
You're popping your. All right, there we go.
Okay, I took a drink. 8% back to local causes. So I guess they got like a philanthropic mission here, but that's
They say supporting local nonprofits and charities since 2012. So I guess they do their part to give back to the community, which is always a good thing.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Commend it. It's cool. I mean, this can. I love this can. I really do. This design is awesome. I
like the horse.
Yeah, it's funny because when you Aaron brought this up and he's like, "Hey, have you seen this? Have you had this before?" And I've never had it before. But I've seen it a few times in my travels, and like you said, the can and the design caught my eye a bunch of times, and I saw it, and you don't really know what it is. it's like Montucky Cold Snack. You're like, okay, I mean, I know it's a beer, but what exactly is it? And it's a light beer. It's a they call it a snackable light beer. 4.1% alcohol by volume, 102 calories, I should say. So it's like your standard light beer levels of alcalhol and calories, but it's a nice fancy horse on it.
Yes. I like the horse.
The horse is
but
nice.
What's in the backside? It looks like an egg. What is this thing on the side here?
There's a horse in silhouette that's all white. The background is blue, and then it's also got mountains.
Is that a moon? Is that supposed to be a moon, maybe?
It might be.
Either the sun or the moon. That's ambiguous. Moon. Yeah.
Oh, I see.
No. Behind the mountains.
Because this was confusing. With this block in the thing, it looked like it's landed.
It's very
this piece was.
I like the graphical style of this. The traffic was
confusing me.
It's very like hard lines and bright colors.
Yeah, yeah.
It's no gradients at all. I like it. I like the way they did it.
It's the official unofficial beer of Montana. So
yeah, that's what it sounds like.
Okay, I mean it's.
I think that's what the mountain is all about. It's supposed to be, you know, like the mountains in Montana, Big Sky country, right?
Yeah, that's what you're talking about.
Out on the range, Uncle. That's what this is. There's a horse. It's rugged up there in Montana.
Yeah.
Never been. I'd like to go there. It's supposed to be cool. But we're drinking this. I guess that's the next best thing.
Yeah, you're getting ready for the trip to go over there. You go over there, you get your cold snacks, and you're good to go.
I'm kind of surprised. I didn't know this was a light beer. That it says lager on it, but yeah, I guess with the calorie count and all that, it would be, huh?
You don't know looking at it. That's why usually anything that's a light beer will say light beer on it. I mean, it's usually what you label it.
Yeah.
Or something that says like when PBR had their light beer, it was PBR Easy, which was you know, some sort of I guess maybe with the name Cold Snack. Maybe that's supposed to say it's a snack, so it's not as many calories.
Are heavy in calories. So yes,
that's true too. That's true too. You could go all out on snacks and then really load up on those calories. But for something like this, I don't know. That's why I said I've seen it before, but I never really knew what it was. So I was like, okay. And it was actually, surprisingly, it's actually pretty cheap, too.
Yeah. Yeah. That was another reason I thought it'd be good to bring to this.
Yeah, because I didn't know how much it was half the time, and then I brought up, and it was, they only had it in a 30-pack, so I had to go all in on a 30-pack. But it was $21.99 for a 30-pack, which wasn't terrible compared to what I've seen recently, that like a 30-pack of like, Bud or Bud Light is like $26.99 now.
It's terrible.
And they're fighting too.
They're fighting.
Fighting.
They are. They sure are.
That's what's bringing up. They're going to have food bringing up too.
Those fights will bring those prices up. Yep. It's not good.
What's happening?
Not good at all. Yeah, that's. I haven't been following the prices of like Budweiser and all that, but yeah, that seems right.
Yeah, I was surprised. I noticed that the other day, and I was like, that's a lot more expensive than it used to be. I remember, like, maybe 10 years ago, it was like $20, at least in my area, for a 30-pack of a Budweiser. not a higher end beer, but like the bigger mass produced ones, not the like the cheap stuff. Yes. Like a High Life or PBR or something like that.
Keystone.
That's it. Yeah, that's stuff like one. That. That's like, yeah. It's like 17, 18 bucks for a 30 pack.
Yeah.
But yeah. I noticed that the other day I was looking around and I'm like, no way. It was like, then there's a 30 pack of Bud Ice for $26.99. How are you charging this price for this?
Yeah. Yeah, I know. No, not worth it. I'm not a Budweiser fan personally. I'd rather honestly have Keystone Light than Bud Light personally. Mm-hmm. I would.
Yeah, and when I saw this and I was like, it rang up because there's no price on it. And I was like, all right, you know, screw it. I'll bring it up there, see how much it is. And it was like a $21.99. I'm like, that's not bad. That's doable. I can work with that.
Yeah, yeah, you got it on stock for a while, so yeah,
exactly, good. Fully stocked. We're good to go.
Mm-hmm. Well, how's your back? Your thing? You got loaded up for the holidays?
I'm loaded up. Cellar? I got everything loaded up. I got this. I don't know if you've ever had, which I'm going to be doing a podcast within the next few weeks. Have you ever had Boxer beer before?
No,
never heard of it.
There's Boxer, Boxer Light, and Boxer Ice.
Oh, I like to try the Boxer Ice. That sounds good.
Ice man.
It was out. It recently is starting to make a comeback, so maybe it will find its way to you guys on the West Coast. Oh. But recently, I posted a picture on my Instagram about the manager special. They had it comes in a 36 pack, and it was $19.99.
Whoa, my goodness.
So I stocked up on all three varieties as well.
Nice. He's got a thing down here in his cellar. You know what he has?
He has
what you need.
He's got the bum
that
wine
thing down
yeah,
there.
Exactly. We're always locked and loaded. I was getting a little low. I was getting a little low on my stock. The fridge was getting a little empty. So I know I had to reload and refresh everything for the holiday season. Yeah. So now we're ready to go to rock into the new year. So that'll be coming up on a future edition of the podcast. Me and my buddy Pete from the Grocery Gamblers podcast. I sent him out a few cans of each variety, and we're going to be going through and trying them out on the podcast to see how those fare. Nice. In the long run. So yeah, we're stocking up on that. Got the cold snack ready to go. So we're all right. We're locked and loaded for now.
Ready for New Year's, Uncle. Get ready.
Yeah. I know, but you're not loaded yet.
I'm not loaded yet.
You got time. You got a little bit of time.
I looked down the refrigerator that I was looking and putting groceries in. We are a little low on a section. You're not there yet, Sidekick, so don't worry. This guy's ready to party. Yeah. You're not ready to party. That's what I'm talking about.
But
he'll get ready.
He'll get ready. He'll get ready for New Year's Eve. Oh, yeah. He'll get ready for the revolution. He'll be stocked up by then. He's got a couple weeks to go. He'll be all set and ready.
Start those shopping to check them.
Oh, it's easy, Uncle. And I did notice there was eggnog in the refrigerator.
Oh, that's just because they just went to Costco.
Well, there you go.
Yeah, they went to Costco and got the dog food and got the stuff they needed. So now don't drink that eggnog so fast with your Koopy drinks. I know what he does. He don't take these. He takes these little grumpy glasses, puts them in there with the eggnog, start mixes his drink. I know what he does. I'm not stupid, man. I know what he does.
I like a little whiskey in the eggnog.
That's what I mean. Exactly what I mean.
I enjoy it. I know.
Now, I have to ask now, have you had the Southern Comfort eggnog?
That's like they make their own brand of. Oh,
they,
you know
they
what
have,
we
they
did?
Have their, did you? Okay,
we did just have that. Yeah, now that you mentioned it, that was the last eggnog we had, and I had forgotten.
What?
It was good. I mean, it doesn't have liquor in it. It's just eggnog.
Right. It's like Southern Comfort. I haven't had it yet. I had a guest on the show.
Does it have those? Does it have the
No, it doesn't have alcohol in it.
Alcohol?
No, no, no. It's just like any regular eggnog.
Yeah, it's just Southern flavoring. Comfort. Yeah. Like, yeah, you add a flavoring to it. I mean, you can add Southern Comfort to it.
Yeah, I'm sure that they want you to do that. I'm guessing that's the idea.
Yeah, they have. There's a recipe on the website. It says, oh, you know, two parts eggnog, one part Southern Comfort, nutmeg around the nutmeg sprinkled in, and all that stuff.
Oh. Yeah. Southern Comfort's not my favorite liquor, so I just usually get some whatever whiskey I have on hand, either like Jim Beam or Maker's Mark or whatever I have, and that's what I like to mix in.
The only one that he don't touch is the Santa Claus one.
The legendary Santa wine.
No. He doesn't like any wine. Don't give him a single glass of wine. But I can drink the wine.
Yeah, Uncle I can drink the wine. Wine. Uncle takes the wine. Aaron takes the eggnog.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Yeah. It wouldn't be a podcast without bringing up the Santa wine.
Yeah, I know.
Not a holiday podcast, that's for sure.
No. Every year we have to make one reference to Santa wine.
Yeah.
What can I say? It didn't set well with me. That's all there is to it.
But this cold snack is sitting well with me. This is really smooth, really easy to drink.
Very drinkable. That's exactly what I'm thinking. Yeah. Incredibly easy. Like I feel like I'm going to be done with this real soon. It's like so easy.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I'm almost done with this can. I mean, 12-ounce can. I mean, this is just goes down smooth. I mean, not much taste to it. I mean, yeah. I don't know how you, it's just basic beer taste. I mean, it's just.
Yeah, exactly what I hope.
But it's not like it's not a bad beer taste, though.
That's what I taste in a beer. A beer to me is a plain beer. I don't know what I'm thinking in my head. What are we judging on these beers? Because to me, the taste is a taste of a beer.
Yeah, it's
and it's confusing the heck out of me to try to figure out what confusing. We're gonna rate these things because I got the same taste.
This beer is definitely. I feel like it's playing with like conventions and kind of like messing with you and trying to like get in your head because the can says lager. Like you're saying, it doesn't say it's a light beer at all on the can, but it is. It tells you lager, so I'm thinking it's gonna be lager. When I drink a lager, it certainly. The typical lager I drink has definitely more flavor than this. And this is definitely a light beer. But again, it's not bad. I mean, there's flavor, but again, it's not like a full-on lager like I'm used to.
Right. It's a very basic beer taste, but I want to say, like I said, it's not the bad beer taste. It's not like the cheap beer taste where you get that metallic... Like aftertaste
that,
with
like
it.
Like that one we had. Remember that one that, his name, threw it out on the grass?
Threw it on the grass? Because it was bad? Is that what happened?
Yeah.
How long ago was that?
That was our producer did that.
Oh, Chuck was complaining that he didn't like it, so he threw it on the grass?
Something like that. Yeah. It doesn't. We don't go that far.
No. That wasn't a beer.
I don't know what it was.
That was one of those really weird, like cotton candy drinks or whatever. What was the name of that brand? I can't remember.
Was that the one you guys had the swirl? Was that the
one? That's the swirl. Yes. The swirl.
Thank you, Bob.
That's what it was.
That's exactly it.
Swirl. Yeah, but I'm thinking of that. I'm thinking of this. Oof. Nothing close to that, though.
Man, that birthday cake flavor was the absolute worst.
I remember you guys with that.
God, man.
That was one of the worst.
I rated it wrong. The first thing I rated it wrong. I admit.
What, did you give it a 10 or something?
I gave it a 1. I should have gave it off the board.
Oh, goose egg.
Zero.
Wow.
Is what I should have
negative
gave.
Negative 10.
Oh, man.
I was planning not to give it a 1, but I wanted to give it a 0, but I was between a 1 and 0 at that time when I was drinking it.
You felt sorry for it. You wanted to at least get it on the board.
I think that's the one time I remember Uncle and I being on the same page with really hating a drink. Because usually I'll hate something, but he loves it. And usually I'm the one that hates it, honestly. I can't remember a time where he hated it and I loved it. I think it's usually me hating it and he loves it.
That was the first one.
That time he hated it, too.
That was the first one. That's the first one ever I've had a taste in. Mm-hmm. That tastes terrible.
There's been very few.
I'm embarrassed of whoever sold it. I hope it's not the
I don't think it's around anymore.
If it was a dollar store beer, they should go out of business, man.
It was from the dollar store.
Yeah, they should have went out of business by now. God, that stunk.
It was one of our dollar store specials right there, yeah. The dollar store has been a bit dry lately. I have not been able to find anything new there in the longest time. They used to be really good at getting new stuff, but I don't know what happened, but because they just haven't had anything new in a while. So that's kind of a bummer. So we haven't been doing
They're running out of my bazoo when I'm doing these these testings on beers. I'm about ready to take them off my list, off my broadcast.
Uncle's frustrated with the dollar store.
They're not doing it.
I guess you got to go someplace else.
We might have to go, if you don't mind, a little expensive places. Because this is a problem for us having a drink. And for my ex-Friday people that love to drink, they always ask, what are we drinking? And I ain't hard to say to them, I have nothing to test.
Yeah.
I mean, they're getting on my show because they always want something to drink. They're always asking, what are we going to drink tonight? What are we going to have tonight? And I can't, I just can't say it.
Dollar store's not pulling through.
Stores is not working for me. I have to figure out another store to go to.
Just have to go to
that's what I'm trying to figure out.
Go to the regular old carryouts like everybody else.
Yeah,
I guess.
You just have to go to the regular stores and go in and just get something cheap off the in the coolers over there.
Hey, what is this the Joe's? What's a Joe's? Is there a little
you're
less
about like Trader Joe's?
Trader Joe's. We got any?
They do have some interesting stuff from time to time.
If you don't mind,
we did the holiday spice
Yes.
Let's go check that area then.
That was very good, Bob.
Let's go check that. Let's check that store out.
We might have
the money to do that.
Yeah, because get Aaron out there and hit the streets. Aaron's got to hit the streets, hitting the stores, and see what he can find.
That's what I'm trying to tell him.
It's very subtly. Uncle's like, hey, we got to go to different stores. I mean, I'm meeting.
Exactly. You're hitting right on the head there. Bobcat, you're hitting right there. He's knowing what I'm talking about. This man knows what I'm talking about.
Oh.
When you want to drink something, we have to find other stores. And that's what I think we're going to have to do. And I think we'll start there.
All right.
Okay. Well, I mean, you guys have, Aaron, you know by now you're part on this podcast with Uncle. I mean, how many episodes are you guys up to now?
Ooh, what are we, 270 something? Is that right, Uncle? 270 something, maybe 280 almost.
280 somewhere.
Yeah.
Somewhere 280 somewhere.
Right around there.
Right.
Somewhere 280, I think.
I know we're right about in line with you, Bob.
Right, yeah, I know you guys went what above me a little bit, because I'm at I think this might be 270.
I think we're over. I think we're passing you.
We're getting close because we missed a couple weeks here and there. So it's a
right. I know. A couple years ago or last year, we were pretty much neck and neck. Then I missed some weeks. You missed some weeks. So all that kind of evens out. So we're kind of still on that same path with each other still.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yep.
I'm sure we're at 80, weren't we?
I'd have to pull up the website.
He has to pull it up.
I suppose I have to. Let me see here. Let's go to unclethepodcast.com and see.
He's going
to
pull it up to see.
My research.
I'm looking here now. What is that?
281 was
281.
The last one.
Yeah, 281.
So we've actually recorded 282. Less. I haven't posted it yet. So we have done 282.
Okay. Okay. So you guys are around like 10.
That was it. 282.
Yeah. So you guys are like about 10 or so past me. So
we're still
neck and neck.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you're at 70, huh?
Yeah.
That's cool. I always think that's cool how that's true between our two shows. I always enjoy that fact.
Yeah, we're right in line. We're right in line. And you know what I'll do to that, since I finished my one Montucky, and since I still have 29 more, I might as well crack open another one.
Yeah, I hear you. I mean, this 16 ounce, I'm maybe have a third left. I think I have a quarter left, so it's nearly gone.
He's got a whole desert down by this. Down there, that's what I like about him. I like this.
Oh, yeah, the 30 pack.
Crazy cat knows what he's doing. And I like how he's got it set up in his area. We have to find something. You know, I'm surprised we couldn't find something to put our stuff in there on the side.
You're talking about a refrigerator?
No. Like he has.
A 30 pack?
No. What he has on the bottom floor.
Oh.
Put the beers in them.
Oh, it's like a cooler.
Yeah. Put the beers down below. But you don't have a down below up here.
Yeah.
That's all right. It's something to add on to for you guys. Add it to the list.
Mm-hmm. I think mm-hmm. I might.
Like a custom podcast.
What you have all the time and having this discussion about your collecting your holiday drinks, it gets to me to thinking, why not me make one of those?
Maybe.
You know what I mean.
Hey, why not?
You know what I'm talking about, right?
Another project. Yeah, I think you're talking about a cooler. I don't know.
I mean something's not something small we could use.
Something that we can just, when we're doing the show, we can open it up, reach into it, right. Grab the drink that we need for doing the show.
Yeah. There's something like that.
Because this is a business we're running here.
Yeah. Something you can do. This we could do on the side of when let's say we go there when there's nobody renting the place.
We could probably find one of those. I feel like I've seen like the mini coolers that are branded a lot of times. You'll see in a carry out or a store that you can like buy. It's a drink cooler, like specifically for drinks. It's got the little shelves. It's got a clear glass door on the front so you can see everything.
That's what you're gonna need.
I feel like
something like that.
We could probably pick one of them up at some point. I feel like, again, I've seen them for sale or something. Carry outs, get rid of them.
That's a job for you, so I kick.
Add it to the list. Add it to the list. You gotta go searching for now. New drinks, cooler.
Yeah.
We'll see what else we can get you on the list for by the time we're done here today.
Yeah.
At least two things, yeah.
So you guys want to go through? You want to give give some rankings for the before we forget to rank the cold snack here?
Yeah, I'm ready to do a 1 to 10 ranking.
You can do it because I'm still thinking.
Oh, Uncle's still ruminating.
All right, let him think about it. You want to kick it off, Aaron?
Sure. Okay. So, I mean, if I were judging just based on the design, it'd be a easy 9 on the design of the can, but I'm going purely on the taste and just drinking it as a beer I'd want to drink. I'm like, hey, it's a night for beers, I'm drinking this beer. I'm going to give it a 7 out of 10 with that in mind, because it's good, and it definitely, considering it's a light beer, it's better than your average light beer, because I'm not a light beer fan, but this is better than most light beers. It's good. If you just want easy drinking and you want to throw them back, this is definitely one to do it with. So 7 out of 10.
Okay, that's solid. That's a solid score right there.
What are you giving it to?
I'm pretty close to Aaron, and I'm with you on everything. The solid taste, it's a light beer, something you could drink all day, day drinking beer for sure. You want to start drinking at like noon, 12... You know, 1 o'clock in the afternoon, this is the beer to pick up, because it's only 4.1% alcohol, 102 calories, so you'll be good to go. I'm going to say like I was going like 7.5 out of 10, I think. I was between 7 and 8. I didn't really want to give it an 8 because the taste is just very basic.
Mm-hmm.
But I was like, you know what? Not quite 7. I'm going to go 7.5, 7.5 on this one.
Yeah, that sounds right. Yeah. Uncle, have you made the decision over there?
It's a tough one.
He's thinking.
It is a thinking one.
It'll make you scratch your head, this beer.
I do not think I'd take it over the top, though.
Okay.
We already discussed that, so it won't be a 10.
Not that much figured out. Definitely not a 10.
Okay, not a 10. We still have 9 more numbers to go through.
Could it be a 9? I might
go 6¾.
6¾?
Oh, wow, okay.
Well, how precise.
Yeah. This isn't the proper push-up of what you call having a drink.
Really?
Like it gets you kick going, get you go.
Yeah.
Kick and go kind of drink.
Okay.
Because you know when you have a New Year's revolution, you go and you take a drink and you go.
Yeah.
You don't have it in this drink.
You're talking about the hard stuff over there.
You don't have it in this drink. For some reason, it's not there.
It's a light beer, Uncle.
I know.
Yeah, he Uncle wants something with a little extra kick to it.
Exactly. See?
He wants that bum wine.
Even bum wine.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. I like this dude. I'm going to get him on my podcast to let him talk about drinking. Because this guy knows what he's talking about.
I've noticed that, yeah. If we're talking about drinks, bum wine Bob right. is
I mean, have any time, you have any time in your time, you're welcome to have him be on our show.
I know. Aaron. Is always welcome me onto the show. We'll definitely lock down a time to make it back on there with you guys.
I must ask, could you make the new revolution?
I will try my best. I'm not sure yet what my New Year's plans are yet. If I can, I'll definitely try. I know we missed it the last few years.
Because we go nuts with drinking up here. Constantly drinking and finding the people out, because that's my big show.
Yep.
Out of every show that I've done, that's my big show. What I do is on you'll celebrate your shows. I'm just saying your shows are doing what I like to do on my little evolution shows.
Drinking?
Yeah, the drinking show.
Drinking the hard stuff, yeah. Yeah,
drinking the hard stuff. And high octane. Out there, whoever calls in, comes out there, ask them what they're drinking. And man, they go on talking. It makes me interesting to have a little good conversation just listening to them. If you know what I mean, Bob.
No, I hear you. I'm with you. I know what you mean. I'm with you on that. I hear you.
I'm sitting there. I'm waiting. Yes. And I'm sitting there listening.
It's a real party atmosphere on New Year's Eve. New Year's Revolution. It's an enjoyable time. And anybody who can, we encourage anybody listening to this, if you have time, you're having a good time on New Year's, just call into Uncle's New Year's Revolution. So listen to the show, just call in, and we'd like to hear what you're doing on New Year's. So we always like getting calls, even if it's just for a minute, like, hey, I'm here, and if you're, you might say, hey, I'm in Jersey at a friend's house, so we're playing pool, it's fun. And like, okay, cool, great, thanks for checking in. Even if it's something like that, it's good to know what people are doing, so it's always fun.
Now, I know Aaron needs to still go out and do the shopping for the revolution. But is there any drinks that you have on the shopping list already that you want to have on tap for the revolution this year?
I always like to have the shots. I like to have a bottle of tequila, personally, is what I like to have on hand. So we'll probably have that. And being up in the desert, I think we're going to record from Landers in the desert this year. So tequila would be in order for that.
No. You're going to have, that. Something other and stronger, too.
He's going stronger than tequila. Uncle really wants to go all out this year. I guess we need Everclear.
It's going to be a celebration up there because we're finally going to have somebody rent a place. This is why I'm doing it.
It's exciting.
The reason why I'm doing this. Mm-hmm. I want the strongest liquor you can find. What will you observe?
151 comes to mind, the Bacardi drink. That is incredibly.
I mean, if you want to go really, I mean, you can go with some Everclear if you want to go like really, really over the top. I mean, you want to mix that with something. I mean, you could get crazy really quick.
in my younger years, I did enjoy Wild Turkey, which is 101.
Okay. What does Wild Turkey taste like? Try that.
It tastes like very strong whiskey, is what it is. Oh. Yeah.
Well, I go a little further for just that. Because of the Revolution is the reason I go a little bit stronger.
Other than that, it's New Year's Eve, it's a holiday.
No
work. Don't need to worry about that. People can get wild and party.
Uncle, you got to remember, I need to be able to use the knob, so I got to take it a little easy.
Well, you do, but not me. Because I'm the producer. I mean, I'm the main man.
You're the talent.
I'm the tangent man. But I know you got it. But you don't have to.
I'll take it easy.
You don't have to take a few of those things. It might not get you sick. Now, I don't want you getting sick.
No. Actually,
next day, but just
as long as it's not the wine, I'm probably okay. I'm really good actually with shots of liquor. I actually, my body does well with that. So if I stick to that, I'm good. So we'll see. I don't know what it is, but my body can handle the liquor, like hard liquor, if I don't go crazy. I mean, if I drink like 7-8 shots, I'm going to be in trouble. But if I just have a couple, it doesn't even faze me. So
I've got to remember the drop glasses. I just like those drop glasses for the New Year's I have a load of them. I'm collecting all of them. From every state that he goes to.
Uncle likes the tourist souvenirs for shot glasses.
Okay.
So he likes to collect those.
Okay. Yeah. It's like multi-purpose. You can collect them and then you can use them to do your shots. So it works out perfectly.
Yeah. Only sure need like two of them. For us, we need two a day.
We've got a few national park ones. We like to go to the national parks, so we collected a few of those. Got some good ones.
Yeah. Well, then it's just something like that. Mm-hmm. I finished that beer.
Yeah, I finished mine too. Again, easy drinking.
So. Yeah, exactly. That's why I had to crank open the second one because I was going through just sipping it. Next thing I knew, it was empty, and I'm like, oh crap, I got to crank open another one now. All right. I mean, it's
because you don't have the 6 can, you got the half a can. That's a half a can.
Oh yeah, well,
he's got the half
the 12 drink. 12 ounce, yes.
He's drinking that.
I guess if you're a beer shotgunner, this would be a good shotgunning beer. You could definitely do that.
Yeah, I could see that. Yeah, because like I said, this is on what Uncle was saying, it would take a lot of these to really get you a really good buzz going with the low ABV. So if you're looking to get drunk quick and really get a buzz, then it's not really the beer for you. But if you're, like I said, if you're drinking all day or something like the Revolution where you're drinking all night, you could sip on these while you're doing your shots or anything else. So it's just something good to have on the side.
Yeah, it's very safe. It's a safe beer, which is sometimes what you need.
We could put a few on the side if you want beers on the side.
It's definitely a side liquor there on the front.
It's a nice little chaser.
Like he said.
Mm-hmm. After your shots, do your shot. You do a little cold snack to wash it down.
It'd be real good in one of those beer helmets too. I want to say
beer helmets
work well with that. Yeah,
I gotta look and see what I might get. Yeah, a helmet. I don't know what I'm gonna.
We gotta get Uncle the beer helmet. Uncle.
Hey, you need that for the Revolution. Get Uncle with the beer helmet with the cold snack while he's doing shots.
Yeah, that. Put that on. Yeah, but what has to happen? Exactly. What has to happen? We got about almost over 9 hours before we start. Over 9 hours.
Yeah, because it's a night.
Because it's a night one. And what it's he's on going Saturday to do, this year. I was thinking of doing this year. Just like he's saying, put beers here.
On the table.
Put on the table.
Okay.
Put beers here.
Yes.
And put drop glasses here.
Oh.
So what we'll do is we'll have a drink, talk. The how's everybody is doing. And we'll probably wind up being passed out before the revolution comes. By the time I do,
you're not
that,
making it to midnight.
I'm thinking of doing that.
If we follow that regimen, I think that's what's going to happen, Uncle.
What? Yeah.
If we follow your prescription there, we will get drunk pretty quick. So, like I said, if you want to do that, that's okay. I think I might take it a little easy as the knob turner.
Well, you don't have to take as much as I take. Because you're running these things.
A little less, yeah.
You take a little less. I know because you're running that.
Yeah.
But for me, I'll take that and that.
I think we'll hit 4 shots by the end of the night easy. Might be more than that.
So whatever you can take, welcome to it. But I mean, it's what you can handle. Yes. Is the question.
I will be careful.
The next day.
Yeah, you got to watch out there for that next day.
Yeah, the next day is the rough part. You got to try to know your limits, but you never know. Right. You get caught up in it, and you start doing shots. You don't recognize how much you've had, and next thing you know, the room starts spinning, and you're like, oh, crap. I've gone too far.
Yeah.
And we get blaming on who? What's that cat talking about? More treats. Just saying.
Yep, we know who to blame now. Bobcat.
Yeah, that's it. It's all my fault. I put the bug in your ear of.
you're the perfect scapegoat, Bob.
Yeah, exactly. You have your shots. You have your beers on the side. You're good to go.
Big geeks. try to make it.
Yeah, if you get time, just call in.
I'll try to at least pop in if I can't hang around for that long to pop in and just say hello and share what I'm drinking. You know, give everybody some well wishes for the new year. So definitely I'll try my best to make it for you guys this year.
All right. Sounds great, Bob.
I'm the one inspecting your cool.
Oh,
I know. I don't want to let Uncle down now. I mean, I put
that's
a lot of pressure
on him. He's inspecting your cool.
He's requested it. He's special requested it now. I know. I'm on the hook for getting you guys the drink ideas.
Because you're the main man for the drinking program.
Main man.
I'm putting you as the main man with doing all these drinking program. You're the main man, so. Don't let the main man down.
Our listeners know that. Our listeners know that the main man for drinking is Bum Wine Bob. Yeah. They're well aware.
Yeah, yeah. Beware.
We've thrown back many drinks together over the years. If it's been on my show or your show, we've covered a lot of different things. We've gone all over the spectrum when it comes to drinking together.
We have. We've been experimental, even. I've enjoyed it.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, we kind of played it safe this year for our holiday episode. We were like, okay, what are we going to do? And like I said, we brought this up probably back in October, I think. I brought it up to you, and I said, hey, you know, it's getting that time of year. The holiday season's around the corner. Let's, like, try to coordinate against what we can drink. And I don't know, because I was out there looking, and I was not finding anything holiday-related that was really catching my eye out there. I mean, I don't know about if you were the same way. Just seems like I'm sure there is holiday drinks, like, you know, we're looking for more like the pre-made canned or bottled stuff, but there wasn't too much out there that I saw.
Yeah,
you know who carries a lot? I've noticed. I was going to Costco for a couple of times, and they sure do have a lot of wine drinkers in there.
They've got
a lot
selection.
Of wine drinkers, but
they do.
I didn't see much of the beers.
And it's been a busy year for me. I mean, 7 days a week, I'm working on something. Either it's work, you know, like the regular work week, and then on the weekends.
Or podcast work.
Yeah, podcast work, going up and working on the house on weekends, again in the desert. So it's been a busy year.
That's
so.
Almost finished, though, right?
We're nearly there, Uncle.
Yeah.
That's good.
That way, it's like, say, this coming weekend, you're doing what? The fences.
Well, I've got to work on a fence.
You're doing
weekend.
The fences.
Yeah, I've got an extended weekend because I have time off, but that whole time I'm going to be working on, again, a fence. But once that's really the last big project, and then the Lander's house should be basically done at that point. So ready we're nearly to there.
And yeah. It'd be ready to win.
It's exciting. It's exciting by times,
that
Bob.
Time.
That's good. That's good. That's good. So that's why we kept it easy this year and just decided to just have a cold snack to just kind of relax a bit. We're just here to relax tonight. We're not going under Uncle's where he wants to go with this high octane.
No, this
alcohol tonight.
The alcohol thing, that's for the New Year's Revolution.
Okay.
I'm setting it up for that.
We're saving it
not
for
that. Not for
this. He's building up. He's got a few weeks to go.
I'm building up for that. But this is what we're doing tonight.
This is what the doctor.
But I had nothing to say about that. To say what we're gonna do, but that's what's coming up that I got setting up for my Revolution Day.
Yeah, no, this is downright enjoyable, and yeah, I feel like, I mean, 7 out of 10 is what it is, but I feel like this is the beer for tonight. I'm happy to be having it, and happy to be here on your show, Bob. And I think it's working out quite well. I'm enjoying
this. Definitely, it's just a nice beer. I mean, that's essentially what it is. It's like it's just a nice beer.
Yeah, exactly.
I usually got them over the tops, but I just don't have it here.
It's not over the top.
It's okay. Just didn't take it.
It's not from Germany. It's not from Belgium. Those beers.
Belgium, man. Now you talking Belgium and other country beers. I take every single one of them over the top.
Yeah, those are good.
Because they are so tasteful.
Yes, you know, they are.
Is
very,
what I'm trying
very
to tell.
Very tasteful.
Very tasteful. And that's what brings it up.
That's what brings my rating.
Yeah, I mean, those are different types of beers, I mean, compared to this. So that's why you know what you're getting with those. Right. You're going to get a more full-flavored taste with it compared to this one.
I remember the one time that he had a beer. It was on the train. You were driving the train.
It was in Belgium.
And the Belgian beer.
Yeah, we were
and
on a trip.
I came down. Did we test that?
No. That was just something that I happened to find. So my wife and I were on a trip in Belgium. We were lucky enough to be over there. Train station, you know, they just have beers that you can grab. They've got a nice variety of Belgian beers. You just grab them, you take them on the train with you, and you drink them on the train. It's awesome. So that's what I did.
But you know.
Man, they were good.
It's too bad. Because I know what I would have rated that one. But man, I tell you, if there was a way you could carry some, just a few, for testing them, for a test for me and Bobcat here, to taste them.
The one I remember that I got from the train station, I think it was a red can. I think it was called Crystal, C-R-I-S-T-A-L, and it was just a 12-ounce can, I think. I drank that on the train. Man, was it good. Those Belgian beers are so good. I had that on the train. It was fun. It's fun. I wish it was more like that over here sometimes, you know? It was enjoyable.
Yeah.
It's a good trip, Uncle.
I know. I mean, it's too bad that people check people out after they go off on a plane and then go off on a train, have to check you out to come to the United States.
You're talking about customs or something?
Yeah,
customs.
You're trying to bring it across and they're not letting you.
yeah, that's my point. I'm trying to bring it out. That would be a perfect way to get some decent beers into our country.
You can bring a couple beers back and you're fine.
Like, you can?
Yeah. With customs, you're okay. If you buy a couple souvenir beers, they don't bother you. But certain things, you can't really bring through customs. You just got to know what you're dealing with there.
No, I'm just careful. Talking about drinks. No, like me and Bob are thinking the same. We got the same thinking.
You wish you were drinking like walking through the airport.
Drinking beers that we can bring back to we can review.
Oof,
I was thinking of that.
I have seen some drunk people at airports. My goodness, it was like 6 in the morning. I forget what city it was in. I don't think it was L.A. It was some big city airport. And the guy was at the bar at the airport. It was like, again, it was 6 a.m. at the latest. And he was wasted. They had to kick him out. They were cutting him off from drinking. And I think they're about to kick him out of there. But man, it was just at an airport. You know, one of the restaurant bars they have at the airports. Man, he was gone. Goodness gracious.
They get away. The people get away. People forget themselves sometimes when they drink.
Oh, yeah.
You got to understand that.
And the airport's a different animal. That's like a different world there.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. I think a lot of people do the drinking because they're nervous of flying. So, you know, take the edge off so that, you know, people have the anxiety about crashing and stuff. So right, drink. Right. So.
Oh, I can see that happening.
I think that's the main thing driving the drinking, that and alcoholism at the airport, you know. So, but for me, I could care less about getting on a plane. It doesn't scare me in the least. It's like, it's the least scary thing I can even think about doing.
Right, right.
You know, I don't understand
it. I'm just here to have a few drinks just to relax. You just, well, okay. It's 6 a.m., but it's the airport. It's like, they always say the airport has like no sense of time. People are coming and going from all over the world. So it might be 6 a.m. where you are, but where you came from, it was like 4 in the afternoon.
And we're drinking
time
something.
Changed and... You know, screw it. The bar's open. I'm going to have a drink.
See, that's what I mean about him. He thinks that way. That's the way I like a man.
It's called benefit of the doubt, Uncle.
Exactly.
That's it. That's it.
Yeah, we'll give him that. I mean, why not?
Yeah.
I'm not judging. I'm just relaying a story.
We're just bringing it out there.
Yeah. It was interesting. It was very interesting thing that happened at an airport, and it was definitely noticeable. Something that you noticed happening.
Right. So I know you guys have the revolution coming up New Year's Eve, where you can tune in. Join the guys here to have some fun. Anything else that you guys are working on there? I guess just a regular podcast every week?
Yeah, just the regular show on Sunday nights. It's 11 p.m. Eastern time on Ocelli.com. But we also do the live stream video version of the show through Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, a couple other streaming platforms. So if you want to watch the video of us on Sundays, you can. We take calls every Sunday, so we encourage people to call into the show.
And Chuck, I mean, Bobcat, if you want to look back on my shows, you're welcome to them because they're all listed.
Yep, they're all in the archives, I'm sure yours are too.
Yep. You can always check them out in the archives. See what you missed out on. Dollar store beer reviews, anything you might have missed, all out there.
That's for you. That you missed.
There you go, a little gift.
A little gift. That's the gift. It's the holiday season. It's a little gift out there. All the archives.
That's the gift I'm giving you. You haven't been. Calling, but you haven't a chance to come in.
Thank you for the gift for telling me to go. You listen to the podcast in the archives.
Yeah.
Unless
you have time, of course, to call in.
Definitely.
You get more people. You get more action that way.
That's where the action is on the live show.
Action live show.
Yeah.
If it's not on the weekly show, the granddaddy of them all.
Is that
Uncle's
one.
New Year's Revolution?
That's it. That's one.
Many years running now. It's been a tradition.
Five,
now.
6 years now.
I think it's like the fifth one we've done like this. That's four hours long. I think this is the fifth one we've done for 4 hours.
Oh,
now we start this show earlier in the night. We start it at what? Well, no, actually, I think we started 8 p.m. Pacific, so it is the same time that we start.
It's the same time, 11, but for the other people, they're not set for it yet. They get it for their time, whatever that is.
It runs for 4 hours, so we do it for a long time. So if you're staying up late, you can call in, and the show is probably still going. So yeah. That's the good part.
You're looking for that last drink, and everybody else at the party already fell asleep.
You're sitting there
by yourself. Tune in to Uncle and the Revolution, and then you can join the party there.
Join the party and get a drink going.
Perfect timing. The show's just starting to get good at that point.
Exactly.
That's when it gets good. Let me tell you. At that time, before we go off, more closely when we go off, close to that, is when he says, when it gets good. But what we got to find to this year, I've got to find Cracker. What's her name?
Cracker?
The one they talk about in the crack room.
This is a person?
Yeah.
It's a female.
Yeah.
Oh, you're talking about Melissa.
Mm-hmm. I got to get to her. Okay. I got to get to her this year.
She's called in a couple of years. Yeah.
She called a couple of years.
Usually she calls in. So.
And because people in the crack room are dying for her. For some dang reason. Where is that woman?
She got a little crazy one year and it was getting nutty and it was memorable. So people
they
remember.
Understand.
Like, we want to repeat performance of that, more or less, I think, is what's going on.
Blown out of proportion, but this... She gonna. I'm sure she probably will have the call in.
The legendary status of that call always makes me laugh. Yeah, that it's always funny that that New Year's call she called.
I like to hear Kevin's. I like to hear what's his name, her husband's arguments with this. I see how he like it.
He's less a talker than Melissa, I think. No. So usually she's on the phone.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's. I mean, again. Anybody who calls, we're happy. We want anybody and everybody to call on the New Year's Revolution. Let us know what you're doing. We don't care what it is. We're going to be excited by it because I'm sure it's interesting one way or the other what your New Year's Eve is. And it's. I mean, part of it, honestly, for me is New Year's personally has been a letdown many years.
At least past couple years it has.
Yeah, the show just gives you an opportunity like, oh, you know, like... These guys are doing the show and like we can get together online and, you know, enjoy ourselves that way. And, you know, maybe even if you were let down by your holiday call in and the revolution will make it fun and better is what we hope.
Pick it up. Give you some pick up.
Exactly. A good way to cap off your year and start 2023.
Is that what it is?
Oh, you guys. Yeah. Yes. Next year is 2023, Uncle. Yes.
I lost track. Track what I'm talking about.
Yeah, it's tough to keep up.
Definitely. If you're out there New Year's Eve, be sure to tune in to Uncle's New Year's Revolution, the New Year's Eve party that Ryan Seacrest doesn't want you to know about.
Yes,
the real that place guy, to be.
That's the guy I'm running against. That guy. But you notice, though,
nemesis.
He has another show now.
He does?
Yeah.
On New Year's?
Kathy's show.
Oh, yeah, the daytime show, yes.
The daytime show. So he's booked, more likely than that. But
he's a busy
guy. I'm curious to see what's going to come out on the ball this year. If he's going to be there or if it's someone else.
I'm guessing he's got his regular gig there again.
Yeah, I'm sure he'll be out there. I'm sure he'll be out there.
Mm-hmm. Him and there's some other interesting ones. Steve Harvey, I think, does a show. I think he might have to be in New York to see it. I don't know, but that sounds interesting. he's hilarious. He's a funny guy. Yeah. So and there's a lot of other. I mean, there's so many New Year's shows.
Oh yeah, there's a bunch of them. Yeah, every channel these days has their own New Year's Eve show, so you can find that. But the real place you want to be with is with Uncle and Aaron on New Year's Eve.
That's what we think.
Bring in your New Year the right way. Crack open some drinks and have a good time.
You won't be disappointed. Come join us.
So you got some chopping to do there, Fonz.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
You get out there, get the shopping list ready, get to the stores, pick up the goodies, get Uncle the high octane alcohol that he wants, the shots, the beers, get them all lined up and ready to go for New Year's Eve.
If I can find some.
I know, we only do it once a year, so.
We'll see if we can get
some. Go all out.
Some desert moonshine for you, Uncle.
Ooh, there you go.
Find some of that out there. See what we can get.
Well, find that. You're the one that's up. I'm not. You do that. Yeah. You know what you're looking for. I don't know the heck I'm looking for. I wouldn't know where to start.
The list is made, Uncle. Don't even worry about it.
Yeah, he's got it covered. He'll get you the good stuff.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Thanks for having us here, Bob. We always love doing the show.
Thanks again. I appreciate you. Always appreciate you guys coming on the show, chatting with you guys. Before we sign off here, Aaron, you want to tell everybody where they can find you guys?
It's UncleThePodcast.com, and then we're also, the social media is at Uncle Podcast. That's Twitter, and Instagram is at Uncle Podcast. And yeah, the website has all the live stream channels and all that if you want to watch the videos. And yeah, yes, thanks a lot, everybody, and thank you, Bob, again.
Definitely, yes. Be sure to check him out. Join the revolution on New Year's Eve, and get out there and check out the Montucky Cold Snack, a solid beer. We are celebrating a cold snack Christmas here on Bumming with Bobcat and at bumwinebob.com. So Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Holidays to everybody out there listening. Tis the season, and Happy New Year too. Why not? We'll throw that out there too. We're talking revolution. We're talking New Year's Eve. So we'll be throwing out all the holiday festivities for you guys.
Happy holidays.
They are Aaron and Uncle from Uncle the Podcast. I am Bum Wine Bob, and until next time, cheers.
I need a beer.